friend and client of mine here at Massage at Norflex. Now, I just want to ask you a couple of questions about your journey.
Yeah.
What sacrifices have you made since obviously now you're in an Australian
and
uniform and you're an elite athlete? What sacrifices have you made with your life to get to where you are now?
Yeah, so the life of an elite athlete is one where there are a lot of sacrifices. So there's a lot of things related to your eating, sleeping, your recovery, doing the right things around that. And I also work pretty much full-time hours at work as well. So for me, it's all about making sure I do the right things at the right time to get the most out of my training. So setting my work hours around that so I get enough sleep, so that I'm eating the right things, making sure I meal prep. I do a lot of driving to get to training. There's a lot of things that go into the sort of end product that we've got at the moment.
So when you say you work full time, what sort of hours you're putting in for your training and your work, and what actually drives you to keep going to work and to actually train?
So I'm an exercise physiologist, so depending on the week it fluctuates, so I work on a client basis, but a lot of weeks are on average sort of 30 to 35 hours a week is what I'll be working. Training wise, I do a similar amount, so that 30 hours a week. And I guess for me, having like that goal to sort of be the best is what drives me a lot. And I love working. Like, it's really important to have balance in your life. I think if you just do one thing all the time, it can become very consuming. So I think it's really important to have the balance between work and training. It allows me to sort of, keep things in perspective and keep life really fresh and new and happy and keep doing things that I love to do.
Cool. So how important is that, when you're doing that training, how important is your recovery over your, and on top of your training and your nutrition that you've actually spoken to me about a long time ago?
Yeah. So your recovery and nutrition is so important. I think for me, it's been a really long journey. Like, I've lost a lot of weight, getting back into training and stuff, because I only started jumping sort of 4 or 5 years ago. So seeing my dietitian and nutrition is so important, sort of eating around training and making sure that you're getting the right fueling. And along that same line, recovery is so important. So if you're injured, you can't compete. So as important as training is, you can't compete unless you're uninjured. So it's really important that you're doing the right things sort of around training, so stretching, mobilizing, massage. And in that, diet comes into that recovery as well, and also sleep. Sleep is massive. Because I work a job that often starts really early and finishes really late, to fit that in around training is really hard. So you've got to make sure that I set my hours so I'm getting maximum amount of sleep, because you do your best recovering while you're asleep. So, yeah.
So how often did you sleep at night?
So I try to get 7 to 8 hours minimum every night. And that means, however I do that, like some days I might have naps during the day, like I try and get in sort of day naps and all sorts of other things to try and get that sleep in. And it really is tough to try and work that in around training, because some nights I'll get home from training really late and then I start work really early. So to try and get in the sleep that you need is really important. So structuring your week is so important to get that right.
Yeah, okay. So recovery, you say massage, and you say nutrition. Was there anything else you actually did to sort of boost up that recovery for you?
Yeah, so I'll stretch pre and post training every day. I'll trigger at night and dry needling, so I get dry needling in my calves because of the impact of jumping. So a lot of impact goes through calves and my shins get really sore. So really important to get sort of that dry needling, that deeper tissue kind of recovery, as well as like sports massage and ice baths. So I do a lot of, after training, I'll make an ice bath at home. There's a lot of things that go into my week that sort of build in preparation to getting through weeks and months, and for me, sometimes 18 month to 2 year periods without getting injured.
Cool, awesome. So let's ask a personal question. What is your favorite part of the day?
when I have my coffee. I love my training. I love training. It's just one of those things that makes me really happy. So obviously that's a great part of my day. But when I'm sleeping, I'm also very happy. And when I'm eating. So if I could probably give you the top 4 parts of my day, it's like training, eating, coffee, and sleeping.
Awesome.
I live a very exciting life.
Cool. No, thanks very much, Lisa, for coming, and thanks for just sharing a little bit of your story.
No worries.
Awesome. Thank you.
Great.